Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to create and send invoices in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. An invoice is a document that provides customers with a detailed description of the products or services that you have provided and how much they cost. Invoices are required for sales made on credit. In other words, if customers do not pay you at the time of the sale, then you need to keep track of what they owe you so that you can ensure you receive payment in the future. Invoices help you to manage your accounts receivable. Accounts receivable is the outstanding balance that is owed to you by your customers. When you create an invoice in QuickBooks, you benefit in a couple of ways. First, your financial statements are updated in real time to reflect the change in your accounts receivable and bank account balances. Second, you can email invoices to your customers directly from QuickBooks. This will allow you to not only save postage, but also ensure that your customer receives the invoice faster so that you can get paid faster. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. To begin, from the home page, go ahead and click on the plus sign and then select Invoice. The invoice form will display on your screen. We will complete these fields for our fictitious company, Paul's Plumbing. First, you want to select the customer's name from the dropdown. If you have not set up the customer information yet, you can do so by clicking on the drop-down arrow and scrolling up to the top and clicking on Add New. In the Setting Up Customers lesson, we walked through how to set up customer profiles. Click this link to watch this video tutorial. Customer email address will automatically populate from the customer profile. If you did not enter the email address in the customer profile, then this field will be blank. You can enter the email address directly in this field and it will automatically update the customer profile. Billing address. This information will automatically populate from the customer profile as well. If you did not enter the billing address in the customer profile, then this field will also be blank. You can enter the billing address directly in this field, but it will not automatically update the customer profile. You will have to go back to the customer profile and enter this information for it to automatically populate going forward. Payment terms. This is the number of days you have given your customers to pay you. This information will automatically populate from the customer profile. If you did not enter the payment terms in the customer profile, then this field will be blank. You can select payment terms by clicking on the drop-down arrow in this field, and it will automatically update the customer profile. The invoice date. This is the date that you provided the product or service to your customer. Typically, QuickBooks will default to today's date. If you are creating the invoice after the date that the product or service was provided, then you will need to change this date. Due date. The due date is automatically calculated based on the payment terms field. So for example, the payment terms are net 30. That means that the due date is calculated 30 days from the invoice date. Now let's go down and select our product and services that we want to bill this customer for. If you have not set up the products and services information yet, you can do so by clicking the drop-down arrow and scrolling up to the top to click on Add New. In the Setting Up Products and Services lesson, we walk through how to set up products and services that you sell to your customers. Click this link to watch this video. So we will go ahead and select our products and services that we need to bill our customer, Aaron. When you select the product or service, QuickBooks will automatically default the description here. If you'd like to enter a custom description here, you are able to do so. But keep in mind that this custom description will just be for this invoice and it will not update the product or service profile. If you want this description to automatically populate in the future, then you will need to update the product and services list. So we'll go ahead and enter our quantity and rate, and QuickBooks automatically calculates the amount by multiplying the quantity and the rate fields. So we've got a couple more items that we want to go ahead and bill. One of the other nice things about QuickBooks is if you have a merchant account with QuickBooks, then you will see up at the very top payment options for credit card or bank transfers. You can actually go ahead and process a payment from your customer using one of these methods if you have a QuickBooks payment account. Once you're happy with the invoice and have completed all the necessary fields, we can actually go ahead and do a print preview to see what our invoice looks like. So click on the print preview button at the very bottom. Now we will see what the invoice looks like that is going to be sent out to Aaron, Paul's customer. You can take a look at this and scroll down. At this point, you can actually print the invoice and mail it to your customer, or you can email the invoice directly from QuickBooks. So Paul has decided that he would prefer to email this invoice directly from QuickBooks, so we are going to do that. Just close out of this window, and you want to click on the blue button in the far right corner that says Save and Send. And the Send Email window will display here. On the left-hand side is what the email information will look like, and on the right-hand side is a preview of our invoice. The email address information is automatically populated from the customer profile. The subject field is a combination of the invoice number and the company name. You can edit and change the subject to whatever you'd like it to say. Same with the body of the message itself. You can change this and customize this message for your customer as needed. Again, if you have a QuickBooks payment account, your customer will actually have a link within their invoice where they can actually click on that and go ahead and make payment via credit card or bank transfer. So once you are ready to send the email, you can click the button at the very bottom of the screen that says Save to Send Queue and Close. Be sure to check your email delivery settings before sending emails to your customers. We covered this in the How to Set Up Sales Form content lesson. To access this course, just click the links below this video. That wraps up the lesson on how to create and send invoices in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click the link below this video. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course, or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.